Warning: sulfuric and propionic acid is corrosive. Wear gloves when handling them. Ethanol is highly flammable. Fire safety protocols must be in place. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make ethyl propionate ester by the classic process of Fischer esterification between ethanol and propionic acid. Finally, we make something that doesn't smell like death. First, we start with an Erlenmeyer flask and add in 20 milliliters of propionic acid. Then we add to that 50 milliliters of dry ethanol. This ethanol was previously dried using molecular sieves that we demonstrated in a previous video. Finally, we need an acid catalyst, and we'll use 1 milliliter of concentrated sulfuric acid. Now we set up a reflux apparatus on top of the flask. Gently start refluxing the mixture. What's happening is we're reacting the propionic acid with ethanol to form ethyl propionate and water. The sulfuric acid acts as a catalyst. I refluxed for 3 hours, but this might be excessive. You can probably stop after 1 hour. Anyway, here we are after 3 hours of refluxing and the flask is cooled. I've also removed the reflux condenser. Now we add 140 milliliters of cold water. The propionic acid, sulfuric acid, and ethanol are all very soluble in water, but the ethyl propionate has very low solubility, and conveniently has a lower density than water, so it floats on the aqueous layer like an oil. We can then use a separatory funnel to separate just the ethyl propionate layer. It's hard to see on camera, but the layer is there. And here it is, our sample of ethyl propionate. The mass is about 11.1 grams, so my raw yield was about 40%. For further purification, we can dry it over some sodium sulfate and then fractionally distill, finally drying over molecular sieves. Now esters are known for their smells, and this ethyl propionate is no exception. It has a rather sweet, fruity smell. Now if you don't want to lose your propionic and or sulfuric acids, you can fractionally distill off the ethyl propionate. It forms a low boiling azeotrope with ethanol. So just collect the fraction that boils below 78 degrees Celsius. I don't have an exact number as I couldn't find one in the literature and my thermometer isn't accurate or precise enough to trust directly. Once you have the low boiling fraction, mix it with twice its volume of water and extract the layers like before. You can then retain the acids for recycling if you wish. Just be aware they now have water from the original esterification and will give extremely poor yields in further esterifications unless you dry them somehow. Trust me, I tried to add ethanol back in and make more ester but only got a gram of yield. Anyway, there you have it. Making ethyl propionate from propionic acid and ethanol. Thanks for watching.
If you would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, please support the channel on Patreon. Links are in the video description.